Is this Mark Levin, the famous best-selling author?
Wait a minute. Let me look. Yes, it is. How are you?
Well, I have a bone to pick with you. The term limits idea, that was my idea. Now you're making an amendment out of it. That, I was supposed to do that.
I'm all for it. Whatever you want. You know, I'm any way we can do it. By the way, where are you calling me from?
Well, you know what I figured out is that the guys in Washington, I have a bill to do it. They're not too interested in limiting their own terms. I think we may have to do it through the state legislatures.
Isn't it amazing they're not willing to limit anything they do, as far as I can tell?
Yeah, they're not willing to limit their own spending. They're not willing to read the bills, and they're not willing to limit their own terms. All big surprises, right?
Amen. Now, Senator, where are you calling me from? I'm just curious.
I'm in South Carolina.
Aren't you from Kentucky? I think you're from Kentucky.
I am, but they asked me to come down and judge whose barbecue is better, South Carolina or Kentucky. And, you know, I would have to be honest to tell you it was a dead tie. That's
not
a good political answer.
Yes, I'll tell you what, though. I can eat it all right now. I'm very hungry. So you're in South Carolina. Look, I don't think it's any secret, and I'm not going to play games, whether we'll confirm or not. You spent a lot of time in South Carolina and Iowa. You ran up to New Hampshire. Do you think this is doable should you choose to run for president?
You know, I think that our Republican Party needs to, what I've said, is evolve, adapt, or die. We have to have something that transforms the party back into a national party, and it has to be somebody who believes in the core message, but also takes that core message and doesn't dilute it, but makes it appealing and talks about things of limited government, parts of limited government, such as the right to privacy, that are appealing to new people that we can bring into the party.
Mm-hmm. And in bringing new people into the party, let me ask you this. I'm not trying to put you on the spot, but the Republican Party bureaucracy, what does this bureaucracy stand for? For the life of me, I have no idea.
Well, I think parties are always who comprise them. So it's who becomes the leaders in a party. And there's always a jockeying back and forth for what direction the party takes. And that's part of what I'm trying to do over the next year as I do travel. And some of it is going to early primary states, but is traveling across the U.S. to try to talk about how we do grow the party. I mean, one of the big issues I think we can grow the party with is school choice. That we are the party for educational change. We're the party that will help inner-city kids who are being left behind by crummy schools and crummy education. And they will bring competition and excellence, charter schools, public, private choice, all of the above to try to fix what is a horribly broken system.
You're so right about that. And if you and others are consistent and outspoken on this and not just... And I know you're not, because we've talked, you know, off the air, and not just, you know, Johnny OneNote. I think it can make a difference, because even today, the so-called Civil Rights Division of the Justice Department has stepped into Louisiana's situation there, where Governor Jindal is trying to open up school vouchers to more and more poor kids, mostly minority, in some of these cities, and they're being attacked by our federal government.
Yeah, and that's going to backfire on them, because what they're going to discover is the Democrats want the status quo. They don't care, you know, what happens to the kids in the inner city. I truly believe that. The ticket out of the inner city, the ticket out of poverty is education. And people keep saying, oh, no, it's poverty. You got to get rid of poverty before you can educate people. No, you get rid of poverty by educating people. And, you know, just look back at, you remember the movie Stand and Deliver and Jaime Escalante? When you look back at that, he went to an area of poor Hispanic kids who even the Hispanic teacher said, these kids are illiterate and they can't learn, and he taught them calculus. He didn't make them rich. He just went in and said, these are hungry minds, and he fed them, and poor kids can learn, and I think the Democrats have really just taken that for granted and haven't really tried.
When does this Obamacare confrontation come up on the continuing resolution, do you know?
It'll come up when we get back. I'm not sure if it's going to be within September or early October, but it'll come back in the first month. And I think it's foolish if we don't stand up and fight for what we believe in. The problem is you have no leverage if the Republicans announce preemptive surrender and people up there say, oh, we're not voting for this because we're afraid.